Hello everyone, welcome to today's tips and tricks. Today, we will be covering how you can use configuration files to save specific settings in your Unreal Engine projects. Configuration files can be used to set values for properties that will be initialized when the project is loaded. This can improve your workflow by having your Unreal Engine projects launch with your preferred specified settings. Similar to how a project knows to load with past plugins you may have installed, we can set the state of the project with the project settings and console settings you prefer. With this setup, you'll be able to share settings as text with colleagues or transfer settings to different versions of the engine. Today, I'll be using Unreal Engine 4.27. However, the same principles can be applied to other versions of the engine and be used among many industries. Let's take a look at how this works. We will first cover project setting options and then cover how to save the settings. To do this, let's set it up for the project I have open here. Now, say there are certain settings that I like to use for each project. We could do these manually by making the changes in project settings as well as in the output log. If we open up Edit, Project Settings, we have the ability to use this UI to save settings for a project, but there may be settings that do not live in this UI that we want to initiate when a project starts. So perhaps I want to customize the way I interact with the editor. For instance, you'll see that when I hover over the objects on the left-hand side, tooltips pop up that block the viewport. So perhaps I want to remove those. Or another example is you'll see I have this path trace viewport active. When I move my camera, it starts to render out, but it would be nice to be able to visualize the progress of the render. I can manually control these by going up to Window, Developer Tools, Output Log, and you'll notice that a window pops up at the bottom of the screen. Here at the very bottom, it says Enter Console Command. A console command is a string that is sent to the engine that the engine recognizes and can react to in some way. So I'm going to type in some commands that are going to control the editor. So I've looked up how to do this for tooltips. The command is slate.enableTooltips, and you'll see that it starts to auto-populate as I type. You can hit Tab to finish that auto-completion, and then I'll hit Space and 0, and then hit Enter. So you'll see that it is a Boolean action and reads false here. So when I go up to the top, those tooltips are no longer there. You can also use the command slate.tooltipsSummonDelay. This means that it would still come up, but if needed, after a 10-second delay or any amount of time you'd like to set. Now I can do the same thing for the path tracing progress. So I'll type in r.pathTracing.progressDisplay. One will turn on the display bar. So now when I go to my viewport, you'll notice that a progress display bar pops up. Now, these are simple project settings and console variables that can be utilized, but let's take a look at how you can explore new console variables and learn how they work. To do this, I'll go back to my output log window at the bottom of the screen. Now, you may have noticed when I typed in path tracing, many options popped up. So you can do the same thing for ray tracing, and you'll see that there are many different options for this one. Now, these are just controlling the render settings, but you can also understand how you could control optimization settings this way as well. So perhaps you are working in a much bigger file and you want to start off the project efficiently. So perhaps you want to play with the quality, so maybe you lower the quality for when the project starts so you can easily manipulate the file, and then bump up the quality when it is time to render. So you'll see that when you type in quality here, we have a lot of different options. I'll select r.shadowQuality, but I want to learn what this does. I can type in question mark afterwards and hit enter, and you'll see it gives me some information as well as the current applied setting. So this console command defines the shadow method, which allows to adjust for quality or performance. It's currently set at 5, but I can play around with this number to set up the file so it works efficiently when I open it. You can use the up arrow on your keyboard to bring back that command you just typed in, which is going to give you easy access for testing numbers. We can at any time check the current setting by also simply typing in the console command and hitting enter. If you are testing and want to revert to the default number, you can type in -1. Now, the numbers you type in will stay while you have the project open, but it will reset to default when the project restarts. However, there is a way we can save these settings in the configuration files. So let's take a look at how to do this. I'll go ahead and close my file, open up my Epic Games Launcher. I'll go to the Library tab, and I'm going to hover over the project I was working with. I'll right-click, select Show in Folder, and when a new project is created, a few text files are also created, including defaultengine.ini. So that can be found here in the config folder. We will be working with this default engine. I'll double-click it, and it will open up my text editor. Now, there's no specific editor needed to open up the file, as it is a simple text. And depending on what project template you start with, the existing core text may differ from project to project. Now, you can place the information we are about to add anywhere in the file. The order does not matter, but I'm going to go down to the bottom of the text file and place my settings here. I'll type in bracket, system settings, in bracket. I'll then hit enter. Now, the name here is not important. It could be named My System Settings or Custom CVARS or whatever you'd like it to be. It simply helps you annotate and organize the file. Now, you can type in any console variable that you would in the output log in Unreal Engine. So I'll go ahead and add in the examples I did earlier in this presentation. For hiding tooltips, I'll type in slate.enableTooltips. Now, the syntax will be important when typing in the information. So here, instead of space, I'll type in =0. 0 turns off the tooltip in this setting. 1 turns it on. Be sure to research your console variable to understand if it has a Boolean action like this one or a defining number similar to that shadow quality. I'll go ahead and hit enter. And now I'll do the same thing for the progress bar. r.pathTracing.progressDisplay=1. Now I'll save and close out of this file and minimize it. Let's open the project back up to see these settings initialize. So you'll see that the progress bar was immediately present, and when I hover over objects, you'll notice there are no longer tooltips. Now let's go back to the INI files I was working with to see what we can do with these settings now. These settings were placed in the project folder, which means they are local and specific to this project. If you'd like to save these settings for all projects, you can save them in the engine's configuration file of the Unreal version you are working in. To take a look at that, I'm going to pull up my Unreal Engine version, and you'll see it's under Engine, Config, and it will be in the base engine file. The settings you add here will be the new default settings for projects using that engine version. If you curated settings in your local project configuration files, those will override any settings you have in the base engine file. While working in that base engine file, be sure not to change any of the original core text, as it is important information for the engine to run. So now that you know where your default settings live, you can go back to the settings in your local project, copy the text, and paste this text into other projects or other Unreal versions. We hope this helps you personalize your experience working in Unreal and speed up workflows as needed. Thank you for watching today's tips and tricks. We will see you next time.